Hello friends. I present to you the third part of the video dedicated to the multi-protocol network gateway SMLite SLZB MR1 with two radio modules. In the first part, we took a detailed look at the design, the device's own web interface, and standard integration with Home Assistant. In the second, I showed real-world usage examples, where both radio modules worked as Zigbee coordinators, ZHA plus Zigbee 2 MQTT and Zigbee 2 MQTT plus Zigbee 2 MQT. If you haven't seen those videos yet, the links are in the description below the video. This part is dedicated to another usage option, where one radio module operates in thread border router mode and the other as a Zigbee coordinator. Thus, with a single device, you can connect and use both Zigbee and Thread devices. More details ahead, but before we begin, please support this video with your likes and subscribe to my channel so you don't miss new reviews and tutorials. As I already mentioned, in the second part of the video, I showed an example where both radio modules worked as Zigbee coordinators. Now I need to free up one of them. This will be the first module, YFR32MG21 from Silicon Labs. I'm removing the devices from Zigbee 2 MQTT that it was managing. Then I stop the add-on itself, disabling the auto start mode on boot. You can also delete it. It will remain in the add-on store. You can reinstall it anytime if needed. Now in the device dashboard, only one connection is shown again, which is Zigbee 2 MQTT working with the second radio module. More about this was covered in the second part of the video, so now I'll talk only about Thread. I go to the Mode tab and select the Matter over Thread mode for the first radio module. Next, the system displays a warning that Matter over Thread in Ethernet mode requires a fairly stable Ethernet connection. In home networks, especially where routers and switches with gigabit LAN ports are used, there are usually no issues. If your infrastructure is old and limited to 100 megabits per second, it's worth considering an upgrade. Next is a message that the selected radio module will be reflashed, and a warning not to power off the device until the process is complete. Now you can start the firmware replacement process on the radio module. As I mentioned in the first part, the manufacturer made sure to simplify this process as much as possible. You don't have to do anything. Just click the button. The system will find and load the correct version itself. Then, also fully automatically, it will reflash the radio module. There's practically no room for error. You get the required result. Done. The firmware update is complete. That wraps up this part of the preparation. Now the following setup is displayed: Matter over Thread and Zigbee coordinator. The same is shown on the dashboard. One device, two radio modules, two different networks, Thread and Zigbee. Now we go into Home Assistant. We need to install several add-ons and integrations. Let's start with the Matter server. In fact, I already had it installed, but following my principle, to show the entire process, I removed it. If you already have it installed, skip to the next step. If not, go to the add-on store and look for it there. We install the add-on, meaning it downloads from the network to your Home Assistant server. After installation, you can launch it right away. No additional configuration needed. You should activate these three switches, start on boot, watchdog. If the server hangs, it will restart automatically, and show on sidebar. Although the last option is not mandatory, you can skip it if you want. Auto update. It's better to disable it and update manually, so you can visually monitor the process. At the time of testing, version 8.0.0 was current. This is the web interface of the server, which you can open either from the info tab of the add-on or from the sidebar, if you enabled that option. Right now, there are no devices connected. Overall, the information displayed here isn't critical, which is why I said adding it to the sidebar isn't essential. The installed add-on is the server part of Matter, and to link it with Home Assistant, you need the integration with the same name. It will appear automatically in the integrations menu. Add it. Check the box to indicate it will use the official add-on, the one we just installed. Installation is complete. Click Finish. An integration tab is created, but no devices are shown yet. Just to clarify, Matter is a logical communication protocol, and physically, devices can be connected in various ways. For example, via Wi-Fi, wired Ethernet, or Thread. Example, a Matter gateway from Moz connected via wired Ethernet with Zigbee and Thread interfaces, which I covered in one of my videos, link in the description. And while Wi-Fi and LAN devices are connected via the router, Thread devices require a border router, which we just installed firmware for on the Esmlite SLZB MR1. For Zigbee radio module operation, the Zigbee 2 MQTT add-on is currently used here, installation and setup of which I showed in the second part. For Thread, there's also an add-on called OpenThread Border Router. It's part of the default list and available in the add-on store. First, we install it, meaning we download the image to our Home Assistant server. We don't start it right away. First, we need to configure it. So go to the Configuration tab. I'll show how the default settings look, and then what I set and why. If you don't specify the port for a locally connected device, the add-on won't start, so here I chose one of the empty ones where nothing was detected. Now scroll down. The add-on was originally designed for use with a locally connected border router, either built-in, like in Home Assistant Yellow, or connected via USB, like SkyConnect. There's even an option for automatic firmware updates. But we don't need that, so we disable both hardware flow control and automatic updates. A bit further down, we enable the option to show and use configuration settings. In our case, these will be used. After enabling this option, between the lines for hardware control and firmware updates, a field appears to enter the network address of the device. That's exactly what we need. We take the address and port from the same place we used when setting up Zigbee 2 MQTT, but copy only the numbers. Paste it into the newly appeared network address input field. We save the changes. We check that the changes were saved. The Save button is inactive, but the gateway address is displayed in the field. Now we can launch it. At this point, we have a connection between the logical and physical components, but only at the level of a single add-on. Let's check the SLZB MR1 dashboard. Currently, two clients are connected, OpenThread Border Router and Zigbee 2 MQTT. In the integration section, another one with the same name appears automatically. Now we need to install another integration, which also appears automatically. It's called Thread. It will be responsible for connecting devices to the network of this border router. Click Add. In this window, confirm your intention. It installs almost instantly, and we only need to click Finish. Open it. There is one default entry. We need to configure it, so click the Configure button. There are no preferred networks yet, so we need to add the newly created one, which is named Home Assistant OpenThread Border Router. Done. In my case, the integration also displayed two other networks, one from a HomePod mini smart speaker, the second likely directly from SLZB MR1. But neither could be selected as preferred, only the one created by the add-on we just installed. Of interest, you can also view parameters of the created network here, name, channel number, 15, identifiers. Let's move on to connecting devices. Here, it's a bit more complex than with Zigbee. To connect, you need a smartphone with the Home Assistant app installed and connected to the same server where we performed all the steps shown earlier. Bluetooth must be enabled, as the initial setup uses it. Also, for Android, you'll need the Google Home app, for iOS, the standard Home app. Immediately after installing all previously shown add-ons, you need to make one setting in the app. To do this, go to the App Settings menu and open the Application Settings. Inside, find the Troubleshooting section and then the option to sync Thread account parameters. Launch it. It only needs to be done once. Now we can move on to the devices. I'll start with a Matter over Thread smart plug with energy monitoring, EVE Energy. If you're interested, a detailed review is available via the link in the description. After powering on the plug and putting it into pairing mode, activated via Bluetooth, the smartphone detects it and offers to connect using a QR code. Point the camera at the code and the pairing wizard launches. By default, It suggests Google Home. I choose other apps. In the list that appears, select Home Assistant, then click the button, I'm ready. After that, the smartphone tries to connect to the plug over Bluetooth. Then, Matter account credentials are generated. That's why we needed to perform the sync in the app. The device is then prepared and connected to the Thread network. The next step, connecting to the Matter server. With Zigbee 2 MQTT, one add-on handles both the physical connection and the logic, detecting the device type and its capabilities, sending and receiving data. In the case of Thread, OpenThread Border Router handles only the connection, while Matter handles the logic. After connecting, the system detected a new firmware version for this plug. So, even that functionality is available. Since the last update, version 3.2.1 was installed. At the time of filming, the latest version was 3.5.0. Let's try updating. Both Zigbee and Thread are very energy-efficient networks, which allows battery-powered devices to run for years without replacement. But the trade-off is speed, so updates may take some time. The update completed successfully. Here's how the plug appears in Home Assistant under the Matter integration. It receives data from the Matter server, which handles the logic for working with the device. The protocol version is up to date, allowing not only relay control, but also energy monitoring. Updates occur roughly every 30 seconds. And here's the device information. Type, end device with routing, meaning it can be used as a node for connecting other devices on the network. MAC and IP address, since Thread is an IP-based network, unlike Zigbee. The second Thread device I'll try connecting, the Acra P2 door sensor. A detailed review is also available via the link in the description. The connection process is similar. Put the device into pairing mode. The smartphone detects it via Bluetooth and prompts to scan the QR code. The only difference, the code is located in the manual, as the sensor is too small to print it directly. Go through all the steps, preparing, transferring account data, connecting to the Thread network, then to the Matter server. The device also appears in the Matter integration. Functionally, it's a regular contact sensor. When the magnet is brought close to the main module, the status changes to closed. Everything works correctly. Besides the contact sensor, there is a firmware version sensor, identification button, battery level and type, and its voltage. Device information. It also has MAC and IP address. Compared to the plug, the sensor doesn't route. It runs on battery. So it stays in sleep mode most of the time to conserve power. Let's return once more to the Matter server tab. Now both connected devices are displayed here. That's essentially it. So, as I said earlier, it's not necessary to pin it to the sidebar for quick access. That concludes the review series on the Multi-Interface Gateway ESMLite SLZB, MR1, though I may return to it in the future, or to other devices in this series, with different radio modules, if there's something new to share. I hope the video was interesting and helpful for you. I'll appreciate your likes. They help with YouTube visibility. If you don't want to miss future videos, subscribe to my channel. In the video description, I'll leave links to all the mentioned resources, as well as to my Telegram channels and social media, including discussion groups about smart home topics. Join in, it'll be interesting. Thank you for watching. Until next time, peace to all.